by the sacrifices. And subsequently, they reached that Olympic dream by attending in Atlanta. And, okay. So we would like to thank everybody who helped to get us to Atlanta. And the reason I mention Atlanta is the first people we should thank are the people of Atlanta who were so good to us. We would like to thank all our sponsors, our minister, our government, all our major sponsors, Delta Airlines, everybody who helped us. And finally, I'd like to tell all our athletes who are standing here that they have achieved something that many, many thousands of people would love to achieve but haven't. And finally, back to Michelle and to her parents, it is a just reward for all the sacrifices that she has made, our parents have made, and it's an example to others that with hard work, you see what you can achieve. Show her the love, Michelle.
Well,
thank you very much indeed, Shay MacDonald. Well, now you've heard her in person. The rest of Ireland is waiting to hear her and to talk with her. Here's Michael Lister.
Thank you very much, Liam. Michelle, congratulations to you once again. A little girl has just handed Michelle up a little banner or a sign from the crowd, and it says, "Mahu, Michelle." It's little moments like that, I think, that must absolutely touch you.
Yeah, it was unbelievable, actually, when I came through the streets on the way down here, the amount of children that were out on the streets getting absolutely drenched. And, you know, I'm really grateful to all of those people who came out.
I know this might sound like a strange thing to say to a swimmer, but you're absolutely soaked.
Well, I'm used to that now. I'm used to it.
Did you ever, in all of the days when you were a little kid and you started to swim and you were going through your career, did you ever, ever imagine a day like this here today in O'Connell Street?
I think you always dream about winning one gold medal, but I never dreamt that I'd be standing here with three and a bronze.
Has the thought sunk into you yet that your life is never going to be the same again? Do you realise that?
No, it hasn't. I think I'm still coming back down to earth and my head is still somewhere up in the clouds and I've yet to realise what's happening.
I can tell you something else, life in Rathcoole is never going to be the same again anyway.
I know, I believe the Putchin still has been inundated with people trying to get in the doors.
I think some of them are actually trying to get out the doors at this stage. Speaking of that, I know there have been a lot of calls since you won your medals for a 50 metre Olympic pool and so forth. Did you realise that there's also been a call for extended pub hours late opening, because obviously they're getting used to this?
I know, I think it's a good job the Olympics only happens once every 4 years, because we wouldn't be able to stand it otherwise.
Michelle, one final question for you. I know you've been asked this before, I'm bound to ask you again. Have you thought about what you do from here on in your life and in your career? Have you given that any serious thought over the last few days?
Well, I still keep swimming. I've got two European titles that I won last year, and the Europeans are next year, so I want to go and defend them first, and then go for the Worlds after that, and then we'll see.
There's been talk of a television career.
Well, I don't know. I'll keep on swimming first.
All right, Michelle, listen, I did mention you are very, very wet. I know you're getting tired at this stage, but at the same time, this is a fabulous moment here, and we're delighted for you once again. Thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you, Michael. And certainly the next couple of years are going to be most stimulating and interesting for Michelle Smith.
She's done us proud. You've done her proud. Thank you. All of you who've been here, and not forgetting the musicians. Thank you so much. Can you imagine what it's going to be like in Rathcoole tonight? Bye-bye.
The soppy, soppy day here. Very, very damp. Early August. Should have been glorious sunshine if it had been. Just think how many people would have been able to come down here to pay tribute and say, well done. Liberty Hall there. Very tall building. And well done to Michelle indeed. Still some music to look forward to here, and a long, long day ahead of Michelle and the other members of the Irish team as well. We caught a quick glimpse there as the chef de mission Shay MacDonald was speaking of Francie Barrett, the boxer from Galway, one of the most popular members of this Irish team, who carried the flag, of course, in the opening ceremony over 2 weeks ago now. So much has happened in the last 2 weeks. So a proud picture on a happy day, if a very damp one. What the forecasters tell us, it's going to clear in the afternoon. So by the time it gets as far as Rathcoole in the evening, hopefully it'll be very clement. Big crowd expected there in her home parish, where they'll come to pay tribute to Ireland's most successful ever athlete, swimmer, at the Olympic Games. Something to mull over there, a little Mars bar, I think, was handed up to Michelle. Some gifts being handed in her direction. I'm sure there'll be busy days ahead with endorsements and so on. It's part of the spin-off that she can look forward to. But as she mentioned, the Europeans coming up and the World Championships, and further ahead, 4 years' time, the athletes of the world will be assembled in Sydney in Australia. So, the opposite platform where the music is to be heard from, you've got the Fury still there, represented by George, Paul and Eddie, and the Heartbeats as well, together with Pete St. John, who was shaping up like he was about to break into song a little while back, and then the team appeared on the podium. Well, the final photographs then to be taken by the members of the press, photographers here from Dublin and other papers throughout the country. And these are the pictures that we'll be seeing, I'm sure, tomorrow morning in all our daily newspapers. And perhaps they'll be able to get one in to the evening papers this afternoon yet. Probably will. And there's Francie Barrett there, right alongside Michelle. And his achievement has been magnificent as well.
That you'll understand.
Michelle, my star, not in the Bannermanor, Bannermanor.
I need to make you see, oh, what you mean to me, until I do.
Yes, I think we are entitled to celebrate. Michelle Arbel, how many days have you heard such bad news coming out of this country? It's good news for a change. We should celebrate, we should enjoy it. We're entitled to that, surely. Somebody has gone and achieved excellence and come back here in triumph to be greeted as a heroine. In the company of family, friends, her husband and coach as well, and thousands upon thousands of Irish people who were just moved by her achievements. The music there, incidentally, just moments ago, You'll have caught a glimpse there of Teresa Lowe's brother and sister, John Lowe, there singing his heart out, Michel Mabel. So there's a real carnival-type atmosphere. People making little of the weather conditions here in O'Connell Street. It hasn't put a major dampener on the sense of celebration in Ireland today. Everybody wanted to be here, who could be here, and you can certainly be sure that all the mums and dads who were able to get down have been pressurized by their young children. Take us down, we want to see you, we want to be there. History's being made, after all.
And I need you, my heart's on fire.
Back a little while now, as the cavalcade made its way down towards O'Connell Street. Some recorded action, some footage from a little while back, and Michelle there at the head of that. Yes, there were big crowds right along the way, heading towards O'Connell Street. It's still pouring rain down here, and they continue to provide fine music. Simply the best. Terrific. Well, cynics may look on at this and say, ah, my goodness, but we are entitled to enjoy ourselves. We are entitled to celebrate, and that's what we're doing here this morning. And there are kiddies around there looking down at the action and wide-eyed in wonderment, and included among in there people from King's Hospital, her own swimming club, of course. Many of the morning she would have gone down from Rathcoole at 5 in the morning to get into the pool to practice, and after all that practice and all the training and so on, she finally became European and then, of course, also Olympic champion.
So the crowd still remaining here in O'Connell Street. And just in case you've joined us late and we've been on the air now for 3 hours and 20 minutes, let's return to the joyous scenes a little while ago at Dublin Airport itself. This was the homecoming. Michelle Smith returns to Ireland. The heroine takes the acclaim of the crowd in miserable conditions. Her four medals, three gold and a bronze. The crowd have been here for 2 hours at this stage, getting drenched, loud in their praise. An Irish woman has returned from an Olympic Games, having won, not just one, but four medals. An outstanding achievement. Perhaps this is a day we shall never see the like of again. So she's going forward now to meet the president.
Good morning, Sakrila.
Good morning, Margaret.
It's Gaskar.
Good morning, Margaret.
And welcome home.
Thank you very much. Proud of you. Thank you very much.
And you could almost have worn swimming togs.
Oh.
The weather, but let me see. That's absolutely fantastic. Well, you're a great girl.
Yeah.
And you're not only great in the pool, you are fantastic outside the pool.
Yeah, thank you.
All the pressure.
Thank you very much for your letters.
Yeah. And, I hope you're going to be up for the celebration now.
Well, I hope I'll have to be. I'll have to be.
You have to be, yeah.
Yeah.
Well done.
Yeah,
well done.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Hello, how are you?
Well done.
I'll say it again, what a wonderful, wonderful, happy smile. So, a morning of warmth and welcome in Dublin in spite of torrential rain. And that, of course, was a fitting tribute to the astonishing achievements of Michelle Smith in one extraordinary week in Atlanta. We're going to look again now at the highlights of that week.
The introduction for the gold medalist in the 400 IM, second in Heat 5, Michelle Smith. So the waiting is almost over now. It's up to the starter. Clean start. Michelle Smith already in lane 5 in front. In lane 2, Carla Louise Kurtz is doing her best to keep in touch. 8 lengths of the pool, long race, tactical race. And Michelle in second or third place at the moment as the Dutch girl takes them up the first 50. Teuscher is in lane 1 at the top, then Kurtz, then Pienhuis, then Hilgas, Smith, Hasser, Pohl and Yamanoi in lane order. And it's Kurtz in first, 28.74. Pienhuis second, Michelle Smith is fourth. Her split time at the 50 was 29.37, which is outside the time she did this morning, 29.12. Now, we'll see how we get on as we come down to the end of the first 100, and already there's beginning to be a little bit of a spread. Kirsten Kielgas has dropped a bit at the first 100. It's 100.01. Michelle Smith is third, second is Wiedegus, fourth Teuscher, fifth Hasse, sixth Pohl, seventh Yamanoi. And at the split on the first 100, it's 100.75 for Michelle Smith. Now, Michelle coming into it. Nick O'Hare, what do you think?
Right now, Michelle looks great. She looks nice and smooth. She's holding her stroke together. If you notice her legs aren't overworking, which is very important. She's going to need to use them in the next 250 meters. I think she's starting to edge ahead right now, so she needs to be ahead of these German girls going into the last 100.
Kirsten Kielgas is a surprise to me because she's being dropped by the others.
Yeah,
and as things stand, Carla Louise Kurtz is in the lead. Michelle Smith is second. Dagmar Haas is third. In fourth in lane 3 is Kirsten Wiedehus. Fifth in lane 7 is Claudia Pohl. And the Japanese girl is last, Yamanoi. Now, let's see what it is at the halfway stage. Michelle Smith is second. First, 203.37. 203.55. Now, we could be looking here at a possible 406 if she comes back in 203, and that surely would be enough to win it. Michelle Smith using the legs, not in the full six-speed kick at the moment, but going well. Carla Louise Kurtz, second in heat 4, 25 years of age. Now beginning to feel the pressure, feel the pain as Michelle Smith begins to squeeze a little and exert a bit of pressure. 250 metres, Michelle Smith leads, 233.87. Second is Kurtz. Third is Hasse, fourth is Wiedehus, and Kielgas is down in seventh place. Well, this is a surprise. If she has a finishing kick, she's really going to have to produce it in a most amazing way, because she's fully 7 or 8 meters behind the Irish girl, and Michelle Smith is 5 meters up on the rest of the field, and the rest are stretched across the line. It's Kurtz in lane 2, Wiedehus in lane 3, Dagmar Hasse in lane 6, and Claudia Pohl in lane 7 is 5th. Michelle Smith turns 304.65, outside world record time, but she's in front. 304.65, second now is Hasse, third is Wiedehus, fourth is Kurtz, and that's the way they are. 305.98 was her split time, so she's inside that at the 300 meter mark. 100 meters to go for a second gold medal for Michelle Smith. Can anyone catch her at this stage? She's 15 meters to go to the turn. In second place at the moment is Wiedehus in lane 3, and Michelle Smith looks as if once again she is destroying a world-class field. 335.74. We were delighted with one gold medal. Can it be possible that we get a second? Hasse is second and 5 meters behind. Kirsten beginning to make a run for it now, but Michelle Smith has 25 metres to go for another gold medal for Ireland. We were happy that anybody got into the final. We were happy with the prospect of a medal, and now we want a second gold. Michelle Smith is surely going to give it to us. It's going to be outside the world record time, and Michelle Smith has got a second gold medal. Who would have thought it? Brilliant swim. Absolutely superb.
She has once again destroyed a world-class field, 407.25. We were looking at a possible 406, but 407.25 is an amazing time. It's by far and away her best time. And Ireland have another gold medalist. No wonder they're pleased. Can hardly contain the emotion, and why bother?
Isn't it fantastic? It's absolutely unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah, it's true. You can't find the words to describe it. You know, you'd want to be some kind of literary genius to write about it, something like that. But absolutely superb. She won it on the fifth length. She threw in a 30.2 for 200 metres to 250. And I turned to you and said, that's it. Bye-bye. Yeah. She's got it. And there was never any doubt from the time she turned at 200 metres that she was going to win it, you know.
Yeah.
Didn't make my heart stop, you know, or go any slower when I knew that myself. But it really is superb. Yeah.
You've won another Olympic gold medal. It's absolutely fabulous. Must be over the moon. I can't believe it. I've got two. When I won my first one, I thought, whatever I do the rest of the week, even if I flop, I'm going home a champion. And now I've got two. I can't believe it.
Well, you've got a really busy program. So what's next for you? Are you going to swim all the rest of the events? Because you've got a lot to do.
Yes, I'm going to swim the 200 medley and then the 200 butterfly. And we'll just have to see how it goes. I mean, if I'm too tired, I may pull out of one or the other. But at the moment, I'm planning to swim both.
Olympic champion and gold medalist representing Ireland.
Champion olympique et médaille d'or représentant l'Irlande.
Michelle Smith. The gold medal winner in the women's 400 meters individual medley. For Ireland, from Ireland, Michelle Smith.
I'm a professional. Call this. I can't clip this on, miss. Oh, thanks, lads. Sorry, things are a little tense in the village. Today, Americans object to Belgian boxers' use of lobster shell. Americans object to Chinese gold medal favourite in weightlifting for wearing shoes. A spokesman said, it's not on. He didn't say he was wearing shoes. And Americans claim photo finish proves that Kenyan sprinter, seen here in lane one, was riding a goat. One objection that did hold today was in the swimming, when Croatian Silvana Silvanikov was disqualified after the American contingent accused her of having too many towels. A spokesman said, one towel is enough for anyone. If she qualified, she would have gone into the final drier than the other competitors, giving her a distinct diving advantage. Too right. We have actually some news just coming in. Thanks. It's the U.S. Marines have rounded up all non-American potential medal winners as a security measure. A spokesman said, we're going to make sure they come to no harm, at least until the games are over.
And America only third. Okay, nothing between them as the last swimmers hit the water for Russia. It is.
And straight away, Gary Hall goes into
and
the
Gary
lead.
And Gary Hall is there.
Gary's really gone out very, very hard here.
Well, that really is a phenomenal swim by Hall. The race is really on for second. But there's no doubt that America are going to get the gold. 3:15.11 is the time we're looking for. 12, 13, 14. Is it a new world record? Well, it's a new Olympic record. And there's no harm in that.
And this for the world record. And he has done it. Zhang Zhugang of China.
And in this 20 seconds, this contest could be won or lost. As the seconds tick away, Kelly is not quite sure whether he's in front or behind, but he doesn't want to make too many mistakes, and he wants to leave himself time that if he is hit, that he can counter and level the score and not lose a point. He's decided to go on his bicycle. They hold each other. There's the bell. And Damon Kelly, by the closest of margins, is through.
So is there a winner in this, we just wonder? Mass control.
Oh, what a goal! Sabah with a second goal.
the Bayern Munich player with a goal in the million. If it's a winner, it's a terrific winner. First there was that layoff. Now watch this. One touch, then the turn, and then this explosive shot. One of the best goals in the Olympics so far.
It's great.
World record held by Denis Pankratov, who's swimming in lane 5. This is Scott Miller, who set a new Olympic record this morning. Pankratov in 5 for Russia, second fastest in the world this year, against the first person in the world this year, Scott Miller. The other swimmers are Michael Klim from Australia in 1, Rafał Sukala from Poland in 2, Paolo Kinikin from the Ukraine in 3. Steady on the blocks, away they go. It's just 2 lengths of the pool in lane 1. Michael Klim is for Australia. Rafał Sukala for Poland, Paolo Kinikin for Ukraine, Scott Miller, and then Denis Pankratov, who surfaced just about so we could get a look at him. Pankratov takes us up to the 50-meter mark. We look at the split time. World record time, 24.19. He's well inside it. He's the gold in the 200 meters butterfly. Now looking for the magic double. Pankratov leads them. He's really destroying this field, but Kulikov in lane 8 is staying with him. Not too far behind. Kulikov in lane 8 and lane 7. Stephen Clark is also going strongly, but we're looking for a world record time here, 52.32. The Olympic record was set this morning. Scott Miller really trying to come back, but it must be Pankratov who gets it. It is 52.27. 52.27, a new world record in the 100 meters butterfly, and a double gold medal for Denis Pankratov. Scott Miller broke the Olympic record this morning. A generous congratulations from him as he takes the silver.
Conservation of energy is the key for Michelle Smith if she's going to do all 4 of these events, and she's playing a blinder.
So what are you saying? Gold?
I would certainly back her, yeah.
I think she's brilliant, and I think she's the best swimmer in the world.
And I think Michelle will come home with at least 3 medals. She's the best.
Good start. Clean start. Michelle Smith in lane 1 on the butterfly, straight into her stroke. Let's see if she can dominate from there. Not easy to do. Smith is in 1, Wagner in 2, Schmidt in 3, Lippert in 4, Overton in 5, Lynn in 6, Millar in 7, Carlson in 8, and it is Michelle Smith taking them up through the first 25 and heading for the first 50. She did it 29.02, the first 50 this morning. The world record split is 28.68. Michelle leads. Second is Lynn. Third is Carlson. Fourth is Schmidt. 5 is Lippert. That's the way they go, and her backstroke isn't bad either, but down the bottom of the pool in lane 8, it's Louise Carlson who's coming through to make a bit of a bid, and Lee Lynn is also going strongly in lane 6, but Michelle Smith is in front. Lynn is second. As they go past, there's 4 in a line, that's to say Wagner, Schmidt, Limpert and Overton. And Michelle Smith's split time at the 100 this morning was 102.87. Took 33 seconds point to get down the backstroke length. And Smith still leads, 102.97. Second is Wagner. Third now is Schmidt. Fourth is Overton. Fifth is Lynn. Now the breaststroke. Let's see what happens here, because the lead could change hand, and Michelle is holding on, but her final 50 on the freestyle is good. In lane 6, Lee Lynn, very strong on the breaststroke, coming through now to challenge lane 1, Michelle Smith. In lane 5, Ellie Overton is coming through as well, and lane 4, Marianne Limpert. So it's a very good race. Michelle Smith just about with her nose in front. 5 meters to go and 50 to go after that. It took her 40.99 to get through the breaststroke this morning in the heats, and she's surrendered the lead to Lee Lynn. It's Lynn who's leading. Overton is second. Michelle Smith down to fourth with Limpert in third. Now, can she get up to get a fast 50? She did a 32.49 this morning in the 50 on the freestyle. 25 meters to go. She's there for a medal. She's there for another medal if she can keep this up, because it looks like Lee Lynn is going to get the gold. In second place at the moment is Ellie Overton, and Michelle Smith coming strongly again. She's got less than 5 meters to go now, and she's taken the lead. It's an unbelievable, incredible gold medal for the third time. It is unbelievable.
There's never been anything like it before, and I wonder will we ever see the like of it again.
I thought I had a chance of two medals. I didn't know what colour, but I never dreamed of three.
And Barrett still putting on the pressure. But I think now he has it more or less wrapped up with only a minute, 2 minutes left in this third round. He's so far ahead. I don't know if any other contest has had such a big gap. 27-5. That's something of a record in itself. 22 points in advance. And there's a bit of a comeback from the Brazilian. He comes back with a few good shots, those straight punches. And it just shows you for a while that this Brazilian is a good boxer if he was allowed the space to practice his art. But Barrett hasn't allowed him. It was the tactics of Barrett in the opening round that upset the Brazilian, and he's never been allowed to settle down ever since. Barrett has been smothering him with blows, punching away like a machine, non-stop. And the Brazilian now, it's a bit late to try and win it at long distance. But anyway, I think he's absorbed too much now, because he possibly hasn't got it in him anymore at this stage. As we move towards the final minute, and we've two very weary boxers now at this stage, because Barrett has put an awful lot of work into the three rounds. You've got to stop holding with her inside and lying on, and no spoiling, or Barrett could be warned. He jabs off with a good left hand to the face, tries to bring over the right hand, chops away with both hands, and they're out on the feet in this last round. They really are tired now, and this is the time when a boxer can draw a warning. But I think with this margin, Barrett could afford to give away a few points. Crack, crack go the punches again. He's punching away, cracking away those punches, and I'm afraid the Brazilian at this stage has no chance. Barrett is on his way to victory. There's little doubt about that as the seconds tick away in this final round. 32-7. And so